So Comcast did fuck up. It wasn't Auntie. I couldn't have imagined why. There's no reason. I've been telling you that all along. There's no reason she would have let this run for no reason. No. She didn't have the equipment that day on the 15th, okay? There's no way she had the equipment because remember, she came here on a whim. She hadn't even planned to come here, okay? But she had hung the note saying, I'm shutting off the utilities and shutting off Comcast today. She went in person, but she didn't have the equipment. And they messed up and never closed the account. But this woman I just talked to now, she says, yeah, they messed up. It's all straightened out. But, you know what I mean? There was no reason that my aunt wouldn't have closed this account. I said that all along. I said, what the fuck's wrong? And if she forgot, it's inexcusable. No, they messed up. She went to an in-person service center, and she didn't have the equipment that day, but she had a right to shut off that service immediately and turn the equipment in on some other day, and they never did it. So it's their fault. As I stated, I never could imagine why Auntie would have done this. She didn't. But there's still a prior bill that was prior to when Auntie was made god over my mom, or temporary god over my mom. You think my aunt will pay it? Probably not. She should. So if she won't pay that, I'm not going to open up internet. It's too much. Okay? They did something. Instead of it being that $155, they made it a few dollars less, $140, whatever. Whatever they did, it doesn't matter. Okay? It's $150, let's just say, and plus they had told me it's $100 to set up. I'm not paying $250. I'm not responsible for the bill that was prior to anything. My mom was responsible for all those bills up until then. It just happened to bounce on that day, you understand? It was just total chance that on the day Auntie closed that joint account, Comcast did auto pay and the bill bounced. But that's not my fault, and Auntie's responsible for that. Do you think she'll pay it? I don't know. According to her, she got my mom the best psychiatrist in Massachusetts she's working closely with. Yeah, whatever. She's trying to tell me it's going to trial just to get it all straightened out. No, it wouldn't even go to trial if I hadn't filed a written appearance. That much I know. It only goes to trial if someone's contesting it. And then she says she's getting rid of the court-appointed attorney because my mom's not going to... I knew all along my mom wouldn't contest it. They appointed her an attorney, not because they thought she's not going to contest anything. I knew that. They appointed an attorney because they think she might not be represented correctly or something. I don't know. Whatever. You know, that the bitch that discharged my mom too soon and left me to deal with it all and is, you know, said she was one of the best in Massachusetts, so... Auntie can say X, Y, and Z. If she could be working with that one from that hospital. You know, the same bitch that discharged her too soon and I left me to deal with it all. My mom wasn't even remotely well and she's screaming at the top of her lungs at me in public. And even if the Comcast thing is not the truth, it doesn't change the fact that Auntie ripped me apart in ways she knew were completely misleading, if not outright lies. I don't like that woman anyway, so if that's the one my mom's seeing, my mom didn't like her either. Okay? And she said she was one of the top ones in Massachusetts, so I don't know. It's good if my mom's seeing a real psychiatrist, but who knows? At least if my aunt got my mom away from Nurse Ratched, then I'm happy about that, but I can't trust anything Auntie says anyway. She's changing the friggin', trying to motion to change it because she's not going to be around. She's going on vacation or something. Again, sugary sweet note, but doesn't change anything. You know what I mean? It doesn't... basically says my mom's happy living with her and isn't going to fight it. I knew she wasn't going to fight it. This isn't about my mom fighting anything. This is about Auntie not telling the fucking truth under penalty of perjury, okay? So Auntie can say whatever she wants in the note. She got Comcast straightened out. She says they contacted her. That may be the case, or she may have watched my videos and contacted them, but doesn't want me to know if she's watching my videos. I mean, it's six of one, half dozen of another. They fucked up. They fucked up. Maybe they did contact her, and she bitched up a storm, justifiably. You can shut off service. And you know what I mean? And then if you don't ever turn in the equipment, they can send you a bill for the equipment, but you don't have to have the equipment to shut up service. So whoever told her that in that service center fucked up. I'm sure they researched and found out. But the fact still remains, is Auntie gonna pay that small amount? Who knows? Probably not. No one can force her to. I'm not paying it, so I'm not responsible for it. Any bills up until then, and the angel thing's different. That's completely different than the Comcast bill, you know what I mean? That bounced, but this is totally different. The Comcast bill, that was my mom's bill, okay? It was the TV. The internet was a small amount. My mom had like to have a lot of things going on in that TV, you know? She didn't want just basic cable. It was her choice. She had the money to do it. I might not even know there's a prior bill. Will she pay it? Who knows? And if she does pay it, am I going to thank her? No. She's responsible to pay it. You know what I mean? But I'm not paying it, so I just won't have internet here. I'm not paying $150 on top of its $100 reinstatement fee or something. I don't know, that's what I was told before. It's still too much. I don't know how much longer I'll be able to stay here anyway. Like I said, I'm not supposed to legally be here, and when I was like, oh, it's going to trial, they just want to get everything straightened out. No, the only reason it's going to trial has to be because of me, okay? I'm not gonna bother doing anything. There's no fucking point anyway. Probably won't turn on internet either. I originally didn't know it's $100 to turn on internet. whatever Andy writes in a note, I'm going to ask an attorney the truth. You know what I mean? She says, your mom's going to try to get rid of that appointed attorney. They appointed it. I never would have. Anyone can appoint my mom an attorney. I don't think my mom will be able to get rid of her. I think it's something that they has to have based on whatever. It said, because you think the needs might not be best represented or whatnot. I just want to let you know. And you know I was in shock. I was saying there's no goddamn reason in the universe that Auntie would have let this run for nothing. And is she going to let it run for nothing just because she owed that small amount, $150? I couldn't imagine it. No, they fucked up. But it's not the Comcast, it's the individual service center. Some employee fucked up, never closed it because she didn't turn in the equipment. So they fucked up, they got it straightened up. But there's still $150 owed, and I'm not responsible for that. I'm not paying it, so. I opened the note, it didn't say anything bad. She's trying to sugarcoat it or whatnot. No. It's going to fucking trial because I contested it. Otherwise, why would it go to trial? There'd be no one contesting it. She knows damn well that's what's happening. I know damn well that's what's happening. Is my mom still seeing a therapist? Does she like her psychiatrist? I hope to God it's not the bitch at that hospital. My mom didn't even like her. She thinks she can pull the wool over my eyes. I know damn well it's because I filed written appearance. It wouldn't be going to trial otherwise. Why would it? If no one contested it, it's not going to go to trial. You know what I mean? Now the question is the rear view hearing still going to take place? My mom's not in the mental hospital, would she be there? I'm not gonna talk, I'm not gonna do anything. I have a ride, I can go incognito. I was telling you on the video, I have this stuff that I can go. I guess if my mom's not in a mental hospital, she'll go and tell the judge she wants to go. I want to know if my mom wound up in a mental hospital again, though. I want to know why she was served her papers at the regular hospital. And again, I can't trust Auntie as far as I can throw her, so. Like I said, I've lost everything, including my mom, so. It makes not a damn bit of difference to me whether it's Auntie or the government. You know what I mean? If auntie's telling the truth, and if it's not the bitch who discharged my mom too soon, or I didn't like, or my mom didn't like. If it's someone auntie found, my mom, I think, prefers men. Anyway. Then I hope that that's true. Again, it doesn't change the fact that Auntie perched herself left and right and lied through her teeth about me. So, nothing changes that, you understand? It doesn't change the Christmas cookie note. It doesn't change the bullshit, the sugary sweetness, the still hoping to preserve that home for your future, which is a bunch of hooey on multiple levels. I'm not supposed to legally be living here, don't want to be here, and I don't intend to stay here. Auntie doesn't understand that things beyond her control, too. Her little, no one know if you don't open your big, all that crap, okay? It makes no sense whatsoever, but what is she going to do? Pay the rent and keep the heat on low so the pipes don't freeze for years and years and years? I mean, it doesn't make sense. Of course she's not going to do that. The second I leave here, she's going to fucking sell this place. I don't know if I, maybe one of you knows, am I allowed to attend something like that, but just hide in the back just to hear what Matt has to say, and not go up there and take part in it at all? Am I allowed to do that? I don't know. She got Comcast straightened out, but there's still a $150 prior bill. You get it? I'm not paying it, so she probably won't pay it anyway. To those of you who say, well, that's a small amount considering you're living there in your mom's house for, I don't fucking care. You understand? I'm living here in my mom's house where it torments me on a daily basis. I'm living here in my mom's house because I did the right thing and gave back that $15,000, gave back every penny. Okay? And left myself penniless.
See, all it takes is her to send me a note and I get upset because I want it to... I don't want anything to do with her, I just want to... The note doesn't even say anything bad and I get upset. Because anything that I get, whether it's from the court or from Auntie or what, is just a reminder, you know what I mean?
Well, that's the good news anyway. Andy didn't do something completely irrational, diabolical, ridiculous, the whole nine yards. They fucked up. And I had told you that I couldn't understand why she would do something like that. And I also said to you, they could sit there and I said, is there any possible way you could fuck up? And they're like, no, why? Is there no possible way that you could make a mistake where Andy closed the service and you didn't fucking do it, you know? So they got it straightened out. I asked the girl, I said, a friend of mine said, is there any way that you could you tell that there was no internet running and no Comcast running for all these months? And I bet there is a way for them to tell. She's like, well, I can't do it on this end. I'm just asking in general. I'm curious. Is there a way for you to, I would think there would be. That to be able to tell that there's no fucking box hooked up. You know they fucked up. And I told you from day one, I couldn't imagine why my aunt would have done this. You know? It made no logical sense. But then when they said she didn't turn the equipment in either, and that, I don't know, she might never have turned the equipment in. According to the, they said, I think, that she just turned it in recently. She should have turned in the equipment a long time ago as well, but whatever. She probably just didn't get around to doing it. But the thing is the difference, I thought the equipment was $100, so this shit is not $100, but, there's a difference between the friggin' equipment and letting the $140 or $150 bill every month, whatever it is, run up every month for no reason, you know? So, good to know about that. Doesn't change anything else, though. Doesn't change anything else. And yeah, we're all fine and good. And now, Auntie is working with my mom, with a psychiatrist, and the best in meth, you know, but before, she wanted nothing to do with anything. She put me down for saying my mom should get away from Nurse Ratchet, because Nurse Ratchet is not a real psychiatrist, a little NP twit who doesn't respect my mom ever, etc. So, yeah, Auntie can do all this shit now, but where was she before when all the burden and responsibility was on my shoulders, huh? Where the fuck was she then, huh, people? Ask yourselves that. Where was she then?